Hi guys, welcome to another section of Learning with Prep Class. I am Tutor Chima. Now, in today's video, I'm going to continue the section of solving JAMB Chemistry 2015. Now, in our previous video, we looked at questions number 21 to 25. So today, we are going to be looking at questions 26 up to 30 of the same section. So guys, before I start, how is it going? Those of you that have seen previous or couple of videos I've done, I believe the videos you've been watching on our channel have really helped you improve on your knowledge of general sciences, which include chemistry, biology, and physics, because if you go through our channel, we have loads and loads of videos and educational content that when you watch them, it's really going to help improve your academic prowess on all these subjects. But today we are going to be looking at JAMB Chemistry 2015, and like I said, I'm going to be pushing through questions 26 to 30. Now, before I proceed with that, student, it is customary that you subscribe to our YouTube channel, you like our videos. Look below there, you see a notification bell. I urge you to click on that notification bell and activate it. Once the notification bell is activated, you'll be the first to be notified whenever we have an educational content like this on our channel. You can also be kind enough to share our videos so as going to reach as much viewers as possible. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy the video as I carry you through the section. Now, question number 26 says, when at equilibrium, which of the following reactions below will shift to the right if the pressure is increased and the temperature is kept constant? Now, each of all these equations they've given you are chemical systems in equilibrium. So which of them in which increasing the temperature will shift the equilibrium position to the right? That is favoring the product formation. So which of them in which increase in what? What did they ask us? Okay, in which increase in pressure will shift the equilibrium position to the right, favoring the forward reaction, that is product formation, when the temperature is kept constant. Is it A, is it B, is it C, is it D? Now let us see. Analyzing them, you see that in option A, we have 2 moles of SO3 to give 2 moles of SO2 and 1 mole of oxygen, 2 moles of CO2 to give 2 moles of CO, 1 mole of O, and here we have 2 moles of H2, 1 mole of O2 to give 2 moles of H2O, here we have 2 moles of NO, 1 mole of N2, to give 1 mole of N2 and 1 mole of oxygen. Now, if you see at, if you look at the three reactions, in the first one, the product side has a total of 2 moles, the reactant side has a total of 2 moles, the product side has a total of 3 moles. Here too, reactant 2 moles, product 3 moles. Here, reactant has a total of 3 moles, 2 plus 1, 3, product 2 moles. Here, reactant 2 moles, product 2 moles. So in this case, pressure will have no effect. Total increase in pressure will have no effect because total number of moles in the reactant and product are the same. So we are looking at these three. I shaded this one because this one is different from these two. The reactant side has total of three moles, product 2 moles, but in both cases, the reactant side 2 moles, product 3 moles. But here, the reactant side 3 moles, product 2 moles. So I said that increase in pressure favors the part with the lower number of moles. In option C, which is this, the left part of the equation has a total of 3 moles, just like I said, 3 moles is here, while the right part has a total of 2 moles, as the product side, 2 moles. Therefore, an increase in pressure will shift the equilibrium position to the right, favoring the part with 2 moles. So note that increase in pressure usually favors the part that has the lower number of moles or the part that has the lower number of volumes. Do you understand? So out of the three, increase in pressure will favor the right, which is we shift the equilibrium position to the right, and that will only take place in option C because increase in pressure favors the part with the lower number of moles. So the correct answer there is option C, where we have 2H2O, that's the right as the lower number of moles. Question number 27. 2CO, this should be capital letter O, 2CO, that's carbon 2 oxide reacting with oxygen to give carbon 4 oxide. This is capital letter O, sorry for that typo. Carbon 2 oxide reacting with oxygen to give carbon 4 oxide. Given that delta H, the heat of reaction of CO, carbon dioxide, is minus 11.04 kilojoule, and that's heat of formation rather, and heat of formation of carbon dioxide CO2 is minus 393.6. The energy change for the reaction above is it minus 503.7, is it minus 28.6, is it minus 282.6, is it minus 503.7. Now, for you to solve this, the formula says that heat of reaction, HR, equals sum of the heat of formation of the product minus sum of the heat of formation of reactants. This is sigma, which is the symbol for summation. So heat of reaction equals sum of the heat of formation of product minus sum of the heat of formation of the reactants. So the heat of reaction becomes, the product is CO2, which is 2 times heat of formation of CO2, as a number of moles, 2 times that, minus the reactants, which is carbon dioxide and oxygen. So 2 times heat of formation of carbon dioxide plus oxygen is 1 mole, 1 times heat of formation of oxygen. So that gives us 2 times heat of formation of carbon dioxide. They've given us as minus this, which is minus 3.6, minus 2 times heat of formation of carbon, this is heat of formation of carbon dioxide, minus this. So minus 2 times heat of formation of carbon dioxide, which is this for the reactant, plus they didn't give us heat of formation of oxygen, so it is 0. So that's 1 times 0. So 2 times this for the product gives us minus 786 minus bracket. 2 times this is minus 22.80 plus 0. So that's minus 786. This plus 0, of course, gives us the same thing. Minus times minus is plus. That's 22.08. So minus this plus this gives us minus 763.92 kilojoule per mole. So the correct answer to that is minus 6763.92 kilojoule per mole. So that's the correct answer. And if we look at the options, we don't have that. So I said no correct option. Correct answer is what? Minus 63.92 kilojoule per mole, because that's what I got. So that's the correct answer. This question number 28. Which of these properties gives a solid its definite shape? Which of these properties gives a solid its definite shape? A. Strong intermolecular attraction. B. High melting point. C. High boiling point. D. Weak intermolecular forces of attraction. The correct answer is option A. A solid has a definite shape and volume, and this is due to the strong intermolecular forces of attraction between the molecules of the solid. So that is why a solid have a definite shape. What is responsible for the solid's definite shape is the strong intermolecular force of attraction holding the molecules of the solid in place. So that is what's responsible for the constant or the definite shape of solid. So the correct answer there is option A, strong intermolecular force of attraction. 29. When a crystal was added to clear solution of its salt, the crystal did not dissolve and the solution remained unchanged. This showed that the solution is supersaturated, concentrated, unsaturated, or saturated. That is a saturated solution. Now, this can only take place in a saturated solution. A saturated solution contains as much solute as it can dissolve at that temperature in the presence of undissolved solute particles. So this kind of thing that happened whereby you added some salt crystals, it did not dissolve completely and the solution remains the same, is a saturated solution. Contains as much solute as it can dissolve at that particular temperature in the presence of undissolved solute. So that is not, so the correct answer is saturated solution. So the solution was what? Saturated. 30. If the electron configuration of an element is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, how many unpaired electrons are there? If the electron configuration of an element is 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, how many unpaired electrons are there? A, is it 2? B, is it 5? C, is it 1? 4, D, is it 4? Now, 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, I've drawn the words, and it showed you the energy levels. You can see it there. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p5, 1s2, electron, we have drawn the electron configuration, 1s2, 2 paired electrons, 2s2, 2 paired So 2P5, notice you fill them before pairing takes place. So it has only one unpaired electron. From the diagram above, we can see that 2P5 has one unpaired electron. So the correct answer is a 2P5, which is one paired electron, because they're asking us in the direct configuration of elements, this, how many unpaired electrons are there? One, only one unpaired electron, and that takes place in the 2P5 orbital. So the answer is C, one unpaired electron. All right, guys, we've come to the end of today's session of learning the prep class, where we looked at past questions on JAM, chemistry 2015, we solved questions 26 to 30. Now, if you look below here, we'll be provided with a link, bit.ly/prepclasswhatsapp. Type this link on your browser and load it. And when you do so, it's going to take you straight to our WhatsApp group. When you join us on our WhatsApp group, you'll be getting updates, you'll be getting infos on the latest content we have on our channels. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.